Hey guys, so I am an educator at an academy and you can follow me over there if you're interested to watch videos on basic concepts of chemistry or physical chemistry topics. You can also recommend this to your juniors and to your younger siblings, right? All you need to do is download the an academy learning app and watch my videos over there. Now let's just begin with our topic.
So it's about 3:30 in the night and I finally managed to come up with the answer key for section B. And now I'm also a student like you, so there might be a few questions which I have got an incorrect answer, but I have tried to tally as much as possible, and I think most of the questions you will find to be correct, right? So this question was there, the correct order of CO bond lengths, and the correct answer is option number 2. Again, I would not explain the answer. I'll just tell you the correct answer as of now, and maybe later on I'll explain you the answer. So for this, option number 2 is the right answer. The structure for calcium hexaboron, this complex, is close to that of cesium chloride. Okay, this I have found out in a book, so I have a reference. The answer is cesium chloride. Trivalent lanthanide ion having isotropic magnetic susceptibility, it's gadolinium 3+, because in 3+ oxidation state it will have a electronic configuration of 4f7. Okay, using a double beam UV visible spectrophotometer, Beer's law fails for K2Cr2O2O7 solution when the pH is not kept same in all measurements, because on change in pH, this potassium dichromate solution, it changes from orange to yellow depending on the pH. So if pH is not kept constant, the Beer's law will fail, right? This I have a little doubt, that dinuclear anion IO, this whatever this periodate is there, has two bridging oxo groups, so the geometry around each iodine is, so I think it's going to be octahedral, but it could be monocapped octahedral, but I'm sure about it, I'm 80% sure that it's going to be octahedral. Rest we'll have to see the answer key, the official answer key, right? So this particular question I've already discussed in my charge transfer video, that for electronic spectra of K2CrO4 and K2MoO4, the correct combination is, so chromium is in +6 oxidation state, that is its highest oxidation state, so definitely it's going to be ligand to metal charge transfer, right? And lambda max is greater for 3D than 4D metals, because this is molybdenum is 4D and chromium is 3D. So the the HOMO to LUMO transfer in this case, in case of 3D metals, is small. The energy transfer is small, and if energy is small, then lambda max is going to be higher. So lambda max for K2CrO4 is going to be higher, right? And now this question was quite, I could not understand what they were trying to do, because I tried to solve it a lot. Maybe I'm tired right now, so I'm not able to solve it. Maybe in the exam also I tried to solve this, but I could not get the correct answer. So I have marked nickel 2+ as the answer, but I don't know what the answer is, because in all the other cases, if I talk about octahedral case, then nickel 2+ has two unpaired electrons, right? So two unpaired electrons corresponds to 2.9 Bohr magnetron. So that's why I marked nickel 2+ as the answer. But I actually could not understand the question well. Maybe, I don't know. But I have marked nickel 2+ for this. I don't think the question is correct, but I don't know. Let's see. For the following reaction, so this is a migratory, this is basically your, when you add 13CO, they have asked the intermediate. So what happens is, first a vacant site is generated, right? So how is a vacant site going to be generated? This basically CH3 group, it migrates and it, attaches to this carbon and it forms this fourth option, this intermediate, right? So this is the correct one. Then the total degeneracy of the ground term of cobalt to high spin in octahedral geometry, the correct answer is 12. And the lowest first ionization energy is gallium, right? Okay. The mass spectrum for compound shows M plus and M plus 2 peak, and the M plus 2 peak is about 4% of the M plus peak. So this is sulfur, because sulfur has abundance of the M plus 2 sulfur. Basically 32 sulfur has abundance of 96 and M plus 2 of sulfur has abundance of 4%, so that's why it's the compound is sulfur. All right, chlorine is 3:1, bromine is 1:1, so that could not be the answer, right? Now for the catalytic activity of copper and zinc containing enzyme superoxide dismutase, which is or are the correct statement. So basically it has been tried that if we replace zinc also, right, if zinc is not present in the superoxide dismutase, even then it shows a good activity. So zinc may be replaced by any other divalent metal atom. This statement seems to be correct. I have actually read a research paper which says that even without zinc, the superoxide dismutase enzyme functions well. So D is definitely there, and I think copper is essential for the activity. So the correct answer would be B and D. That is option number 4. Right, this is either 1 or 3. I'm not sure. I got a little confused, so I'm not sure about this. It's either 1 or 3, one of them. Okay, removal of electron from NO molecule results in, so basically from 2.5 bond order it converts to a bond order of 3. So basically your NO bond becomes really strong, so it will show a higher IR spectrum, like the stretching frequency will be higher in the IR spectrum. So option number A is definitely correct. Option B is incorrect. An EPR active species, basically NO is paramagnetic, but if you remove an electron it turns into diamagnetic, that is it does not have any unpaired electron. So B is not the right answer. And C is actually the correct one, that electrons in HOMOs become closer to oxygen. So if we remove one electron, then the HOMO becomes closer to oxygen, whereas if there is one electron present, that is the original NO molecule, then the HOMO is closer to nitrogen. But once we remove the electron, the HOMO becomes closer to your oxygen. So the correct answer is A and C, that is option number 2. Now these are some organic questions. So this one is a reducing agent, lithium aluminium hydride, and since we have a OH, this OH coordinates to this aluminium, and there's a complex formation taking place, and then we add this electrophile, that is iodine. So this product is formed. This is your cis alkene, right? So option number 1. This is a straightforward question from Carothers, like it is a copy paste from Carothers. And so basically your MnO2 is oxidizing agent, and it leads to the oxidation of allylic alcohols to carboxylic acids, and then this oxygen attacks this carboxylic acid to form this 6-membered ring, and this is the correct answer, option number 3. Okay, this I'm not sure about, but first of all, see, N-butyl lithium is there, so it will abstract the most acidic proton. Or you can think about it that wherever the lithium gets attached, that will be the most stabilized carbon ion. So if lithium gets attached over here, this is the benzylic position, it will be stabilized due to resonance, right? One is this position, the allylic position, and one is this benzylic position. So benzylic position will be highly stabilized. So the lithium will get attached over here. So basically the proton will be abstracted from here, and then some kind of reaction takes place, which I'll explain the mechanism later, and we get option number A as the correct answer. I'm not sure about this, okay? This is simple Birch reduction. We have a indole, and if we do a Birch reduction of indole, basically the deficient, the more deficient nucleus gets reduced. So the more deficient ring over here is this phenyl ring, and this is an electron rich ring because of the lone pair of nitrogen. So the correct answer is option number 4 in this case. 40th question, correct answer is option number 2. Okay, basically we are nucleophilic reaction is taking place. So acetyl chloride is highly susceptible to nucleophilic reactions. So this will undergo the nucleophilic substitution the fastest. So option number 2 is the correct answer. For 41, A is aromatic and B is anti-aromatic, since oxygen's lone pair also participate in resonance. So it becomes a 4N pi system. So A is aromatic and B is anti-aromatic. That is option number 2. Then this is simply IOPAC nomenclature. This was asked earlier also. There was a question on 9-bora bicyclononane. So it is somewhat similar, and the correct answer is 4th option, that is tricyclo-11013-pentane, right? Then this is solvolysis reaction. Solvolysis basically means it follows your SN1 reaction. So basically you have to see the carbocation. So the carbocation will be the most stabilized in this case, option number C. Then option number A and then B. Why B is not preferred? Because of Bredit's rule. Because over here sp2 hybridized carbon is not preferred, but if we do SN1 reaction and carbocation is formed, then basically carbocation is also sp2 hybridized. So it will be very, very unstable. So that is why the correct answer will be C will go the fastest, solve this, followed by A and then B, right? So this is a totally it's totally basically mugging up question, and the correct answer is option number A. It's basically asking the ninhydrin what kind of complex the ninhydrin agent forms with the amino acid. So this is the complex that is formed which gives color. So this is option number one. So number of signals observed in 13C NMR, so the correct answer is 6, right? So there are the correct answer is 6 basically. This is a Gaussian distribution function given to us, and this is physical part that is starting. So the variance of such distribution is variance is basically nothing but this A square. So it's 2 by sigma square. This A square is a variance, and if they had asked you the standard deviation, then it is root of A square, that it would have been A, but since they are asking the variance, it's A square. The term symbol for ground state B2 is, this is molecular term symbols, this is the correct answer, option number 3. Commutator of X and Hamiltonian, the commutator is I H cross by M PX, right? The lowest energy state of 1s1 2s1 electronic configuration is 3s1, option number 3. The units of rate constant for the reaction, this simple question, that is 4. This is again a simple question, delta G is equal to minus NF E naught, and since the standard cell potential is positive, so the answer is definitely going to be negative, and it is going to be in kilojoules, because if you calculate properly, it will come out to be in kilojoules, and if you do the calculations are actually very simple, it comes out to be option number 3. Then the change in entropy for a reversible adiabatic process is, the answer is 0. Just go through the concept once, it's pretty easy, right? Then there are few questions, physical questions that I've missed out. I was not sure about the answer. So these are, I think there are two or three questions from physical chemistry I've missed out. So I'll cover them later if I find the answer. And in case you have some doubts, please feel free to comment below and let me know. Okay. Correct match for the coenzymes in column A with their function in column B. The correct answer is option number 2. Okay. So basically your NADH leads to your reduction, FAD leads to oxidation, and this is coenzyme A. Coenzyme A basically does a function of acyl group transfer, right? From fatty acids, it transfers acyl group. And this was a question for Langevin adsorption, that what is the correct graph for the Langevin adsorption? So this is the correct graph, option number 4, right? So this is the correct graph for Langevin adsorption, right? So these are the questions from section B. I think I missed out 4 or 5 questions in total. I think one from organic, and which I was not sure about, one from inorganic, and 3 questions from physical. So 34-35 questions I've covered. So I hope you found this video useful. If you have any doubts, or if you feel that I have incorrectly marked the answer, please feel free to comment below and have a healthy discussion, right? Thank you so much for watching.